Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jenny. I'm here today to chat to you a bit about book series, when to keep going, when to abandon, and obviously this is just my opinion, but I think that sometimes you need a little push to give yourself permission to let go of a series that isn't feeding you, that isn't something you're reading purely for pleasure, and I'm just going to talk about that a little bit today. So this video is inspired by a video that Gemma from Gemma Books made a while ago. It was basically her outlining all the series that she's currently reading that she has not finished, and just like making a list for herself. And while I was watching that, I was thinking obviously about my own series lists, and you know, the ones I finished, the ones I haven't, and the ones that I've abandoned. And I have abandoned some, and so I thought I would talk about why that is today. Some of these I did talk a little bit about in my book adaptation video, so if you're interested in that, hearing a bit more on some of them, you can head out and check that video. But yeah, so I'm gonna get started. I'm gonna first talk about some of the series that I finished. So there are some books I'm not going to, series that I've read I'm not going to mention here. Some of them are YA and middle grade series that I've read with my sons. But, you know, Harry Potter, we read all of those together. We've read a couple other trilogies, or are in the midst of reading a few trilogies. I kind of like trilogies. I think trilogies are a sweet spot for a series of books, because it's not a, you know, a monumental commitment. It's a big commitment because you have to read three, but you don't have to think about reading 5 to 12 books, okay? So that is a lot. So two series that I have, one I've completed, one I have not, I talked about in the book adaptation video. That is the Wheel of Time series by Robert Jordan and Game of Thrones by George R.R. Martin. I finished The Wheel of Time. I did not finish Game of Thrones. I will not finish Game of Thrones. I can't currently finish it because he still hasn't released the final books, but I decided to abandon that series. And some of the series that I read with my sons, we decided to abandon as well. So why would you make those decisions? What is your criteria for abandonment? What is my criteria for abandonment? First of all, time. I think time is a huge factor. When you are waiting for a book, such as you've been waiting, like fans have been waiting for George R.R. Martin's next book in the Game of Thrones series, and an entire TV series has ellipsed in that time and finished and wrapped up. For me, that's a bit of a dissuader. I'm not that invested in the story. And I think super fans who are really, really into the story are going to want to continue. But for me, I was not that invested in the books. I liked the characters. There was a lot of things about the story that I really liked. And I felt that the TV show had encompassed enough of that for me. So when I realized that I'd gotten what I wanted to get out of the TV show, I thought, why continue reading those books whenever they happen to come out? It's just not important to me. And it was the same thing for us in a series called Wings of Fire, which got to a very clean kind of ending and then expanded the universe. So there was a first series of, I believe, 6 or 7 books. And when you got to the 7th book, there was a kind of expansion of the universe into a whole other set of characters, which I'm sure loop back to the original characters of the story. But all of us thought, you know, we feel resolved in the story and we don't need to continue. It's just too much of an investment of time, and we're not as invested in the world as we were at the beginning. We've gotten to a nice place to stop, so that's what we decided to do. Not all series are like that, obviously. Outlander, for example, which I really enjoyed the first couple books, And then as the books went on, I found they had a sense of repetition for me, a sense of a pattern that was forming in the way the stories were being told that started to get tedious, especially when you're reading over 1,000 pages. And also at the same time, there was the TV show. And the TV show is continuing to follow a lot of the book. And so for me, I thought, you know what? I can watch the TV show and still experience these characters and still continue on the story without having to invest as much time reading these pages and going through the ups and downs of the story arc that this author seems to like to do. And so I decided to abandon that series. I think I got to book 4, and that was enough for me. I actually just abandoned a series this month as well. And this is a trilogy, and like I said, trilogies are kind of a sweet spot for me, so I was very committed to finishing the book. But a few things happened when I was trying to get this book. A, I waited too long to get it from my library, and someone either never returned it or they took it out of circulation because it's quite an obscure series. It's the Mayfair Witches series by Anne Rice. I had purchased the first book at a library book sale and did not realize it was the first in a trilogy when I purchased it. So that threw me off because I wasn't planning on reading a trilogy. I thought it was a standalone, and then I thought, okay, I'll read the next one. So I got the next one out from the library several years ago now and had the other one on my list. And I was like, okay, it's October, it's a witchy read, it's fitting my mood, so I'm gonna get it out. And then it was no longer available at my library. So then I thought, okay, I'm gonna buy this book and finish the series. I need to finish the series. So I was going to buy the book, but when I looked at it, it was I think $13 on Kindle, and it was in a mass market paperback format, so it's over a 500 page book in a mass market paperback, which is not a reading experience I enjoy in terms of the size. I didn't want to buy the hardcover because it was very expensive, and I thought, you know, how invested am I in this series that I really need to read the last book? I felt that the second book resolved a lot of the characters, and this third book was going to go and be kind of a prequel, going back in time to the origins of this family. And I thought, do I really need that to close off these characters for me? And I didn't. And I thought, you know, owning this book is not necessary. I'm not as invested in these characters as I need to be in order to buy this book, and so I decided to abandon the series. So for me, these are all the things that you take into consideration when you're deciding whether or not you want to continue. How invested are you in finding out the end of the story? Is it worth it to purchase these books if you can't get them in another way? Because for me, you know, the likelihood of me rereading a series is quite low, and I don't want to purchase books just to be able to say that I finished reading them unless I really, really love the story and I'm super invested. An example of this, the Bangladesh series by Tahmima, Anam. I loved the first two of these books. I got them both from the library, and as far as I can tell, the third one is not available at the library. So I am going to purchase it, and I'm hoping that I can purchase all three in a set because they are beautiful stories that I really love and I will probably reread at some point in my life. And even if I don't reread them, I'll be proud to own those books. And so that is an example of a series that I will not abandon, that I will finish, and that I'm very committed to. And Tahmima Anam actually has just released a new book, so I feel very, you know, determined now that I need to get this third one, read it, and then move on and read her next novel. So there are some series and some authors that I think are worth that, and it's about a real passion and love. If you have a real passion and love for their work and the series and the characters, then you will go to great lengths to finish their books. I feel the same way about the Manawaka sequence, which is not necessarily a series. It's kind of a different version of this. It's Margaret Laurence wrote The Diviners, which is my favorite novel of all time. And she also wrote other books that take place in this same fictional town. And so I have read two of them, and there are five in total. So I would like to read the other three just to complete it and have this sense of all that she wanted to say about this town. And so that is another one that I will be definitely completing in the future. So there's a lot of things that you need to consider when you're thinking about whether or not to continue finishing a series. I really think that it's not necessarily something you should hold over your head and like worry about, oh, I haven't finished it, oh, I haven't finished it, because ultimately, not all series books are created equally. And sometimes you're in the middle of a series and the books have gotten really stale, or the format is no longer something that appeals to you, and it might be worth abandoning it. Some other books, the series that I've finished, Anne of Green Gables by Lucy Maud Montgomery. I've read all the books that Louisa May Alcott wrote around the whole world of Little Women. Were they all as good as the original? No, they were not. Did I love the characters enough to keep reading them because I wanted to be in that world? Yes, I did. So I think that's a huge part of it. I know if you're a plot reader versus a character reader, I'm not sure how that works in terms of a series. So if you consider yourself to be a plot reader and you finish series, I'd love to know why in the comments. Like, let me know what, or make a video in response to this and let me know. Because I am curious how that works if you're a plot person and you read series. Because to me, a series is about the characters. It's about you caring enough to want to keep going with these people and see them through whatever they're going through. And I guess if you're talking about cozy mystery or that type of a book, then you want to see what the characters are going to deal with next. Maybe that's your motivation. But for me, it's always like an attachment to these characters, wanting to know what happens to them, wanting to keep being with them and follow them through whatever happens next. And you know, I don't think you should feel bad if you decide to abandon a book. It is what it is. We only have so many things to read, and I am a completionist in so, so, so many ways, which I've talked about before on this channel. So I do not take abandoning a series lightly, but I also want to preserve my reading time for things that I feel like I'm really going to enjoy. And sometimes you get motivated to read through a series for outside factors. One of those was finishing the Thomas Cromwell series by Hilary Mantel, because I had read Wolf Hall with a group read-along, which was really enjoyable. Then The Mirror and the Light was a finalist for the BookTube prize, and I had not read Bring Up the Bodies. And I knew I wanted to read Bring Up the Bodies, and so I refused to read The Mirror and the Light until I'd read Bring Up the Bodies. So that motivated me to get through that whole series much faster than I normally would. And now I can say that I've read it. So there's sometimes these factors that play into whether or not we're going to read a series. In other cases, I've read books that were part of a series that I really didn't enjoy and had no desire to go back and read the previous versions of them as well. So that could also happen. The other series that I finished that I just wanted to mention quickly was Seed to Harvest by Octavia E. Butler. And that one I read because I was doing a read-along with live reading sprints over YouTube over the course of, I think we read all the books in about 6 to 8 months. And I really did enjoy that experience. I don't think I would have read all of them that quickly if I wouldn't have been reading it in the read-along experience. So there is something to say for reading series in that way. I think it might be a new way that I look into reading series in the future if I see another series coming up that someone's going to do a read-along for. Maybe I should do a read-along for a series. I don't know. I will see in the future if that happens, but do keep that in mind if you see that coming. If there's a series of books that you have always wanted to try but never got into it, but you see that there's a read-along, because I think that's a really great motivator, and it's really enjoyable to read with other people and get their experiences along the way while you're reading those. So I think that's all I have to say about series today. I'm gonna leave you there. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.